there's a very exciting, very rare event that's about to happen. In America, on April 8th, 2024, there will be a total solar eclipse. Americans, you need to be somewhere along this path on April 8th. If you're not there, you're going to miss one of the coolest astronomical events ever. And there won't be another one here for two decades. To my international fans, we would love for you to come visit us. But you'll have other chances. There'll be one in Spain and Iceland in 2026, one in North Africa in 2027, one in Australia in 2028, one in China and Japan in 2035. South Americans, I hope you saw the one in 2020. You'll have to wait till 2045. It's hard for me to explain what it's like to see a total solar eclipse. The best way I can describe it is, whoa, whoa. Like, I can tell you all the things that happen, but I can't explain what's so magical about it. You just have to see it. I'm going to play for you a little audio of when I watched a total solar eclipse with my family. Here's the moment when the sun goes behind the moon. A solar eclipse happens when the moon casts a shadow on the Earth. A lunar eclipse happens when the Earth casts a shadow on the moon. Lunar eclipses are worth checking out, but they happen every year or two, and they're not that exciting. Here's what happens. The Earth's shadow falls on the moon. The moon turns dark red. It's red because there's light that's traveling through Earth's atmosphere. The red light is what remains after the blue light is scattered away, much like a sunset. The moon orbits the Earth every 29 days, but we don't see an eclipse on every orbit. The moon orbits the Earth in an elliptical path, and the Earth orbits the sun in an elliptical path. These two orbits are almost aligned, but not exactly aligned. The moon's orbit is inclined away from the Earth's orbit by 5 degrees. From our perspective, the moon's orbit sometimes goes above the sun, sometimes below the sun. Sometimes the moon blocks part of the sun. Only very rarely does the moon block all of the sun. There are three types of solar eclipse: a partial eclipse, a total eclipse, and an annular eclipse. A partial eclipse means that part of the sun is blocked. A total eclipse means that all of the sun is blocked. The moon's orbit is not a perfect circle. Sometimes the moon is closer to the Earth, and sometimes it's further away. When it's further away, it looks smaller, and it may only block the center of the sun, leaving behind a ring. The word ring in Latin is annulus, and this is called an annular eclipse. From our perspective, the sun and moon appear to be roughly the same size. This seems to be a strange coincidence. The sun is much larger and much further away than the moon, and it just happens they appear to be the same size. During an eclipse, you'll see the moon slowly blocking more of the sun, leaving behind a crescent shape. But you'll see the same crescent shape, not in the sky, but down on the ground beneath the trees. To understand this, we need to understand how cameras work. Let's imagine you have a light source with many different colors, and it's shining on a wall. Each point on the wall receives light from all directions. It receives all these different colors, and the colors on the wall blend together. Now imagine we block off most of the light and only allow light to come in through a small hole. Now at each point on the wall, light can only come in from one direction. The colors are not blended together. You will see an image of the light source projected onto the wall. This is how cameras work. Cameras have a small hole behind the lens. Light comes in through the hole and projects onto a piece of film or a light sensor. This is also how your eyes work. Each eye has a small hole behind the lens. The light comes in through the hole and projects onto your retina, which is covered in cells that can detect light. You can see this effect directly. You just need to create a situation where light can only come in through one hole. Just block off all the light from your doors and windows, and then create a small hole. At first, I tried cutting a hole in a piece of cloth, but the cloth didn't block enough of the light. Then I used cardboard, which was much better. The only light coming into my bedroom is from this one hole. You can now see an image of what's outside my room projected into my room. I went outside and started waving my hands outside my room. You can now see an image of me waving my hands projected into the room. But notice that my image is upside down. During a partial eclipse, there'll be a crescent shape in the sky. This is the light source. Anywhere there's a small hole, you'll see that crescent shape projecting out from it.
As you can see, there are little tiny crescents. The sunlight coming through the foliage, there's a million little pinhole cameras and forms the image of the sun on the ground.
Now, this partial eclipse stuff is kind of fun, but all the really exciting things happen during a total solar eclipse. If you want to experience this, you need to be somewhere along this path on April 8th, 2024. You could be in Mexico, Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, Missouri, Kentucky, Illinois, Indiana, Ohio, Pennsylvania, New York, Vermont, New Hampshire, Maine, or Canada. Also, check the weather forecast. If it's cloudy, you won't see much of anything.
Only look at the sun through solar eclipse glasses. Otherwise, you can permanently damage your eyes.
In 2017, I went to Idaho to see an eclipse with my family. It was the first total solar eclipse I'd ever seen. I actually missed the previous one in America, but I did have a good excuse. I hadn't been born. This was 1979. Total solar eclipses are very rare. For the US, there was one in 1979, 2017, and then 2024. There won't be another one till 2045. Now, as you get closer to totality, more and more interesting things happen. I downloaded an app called Solar Eclipse Timer that tells you when various things are going to happen.
This is so exciting. We're almost to a minute.
A minute before totality, my app says,
60 seconds. Observe for shadow bands.
Where's the shadow band?
And then we see them. We run over the driveway and there's these like weird wavy lines just dancing around on the driveway. It's actually caused by refraction and turbulence in the atmosphere.
30 seconds! 30 seconds!
Right before totality, you'll see the diamond ring effect and what's called Bailey's beads. When the sun is completely behind the moon, this is when the magic happens. It suddenly gets dark. You can take off your glasses.
10 seconds.
It's dark. 7, 6, 5.
Oh my goodness.
1, 2, 1.
Whoa.
Oh my
God.
I don't know what it is about this experience, but it just feels incredible. You can see stars now. Scientists actually needed a solar eclipse to be able to test Einstein's theory of relativity because they needed to observe stars near the sun. This magical moment won't last long. You'll get 3 or 4 minutes tops. When totality ends, put your glasses back on. The sun's coming back. This is not a long experience, but I think it's worth it.
So cool!
My family loved it.
It was awesome.
Yeah? Zach, you like it?
It was awesome.
Yeah.
It's too hard to explain it.
Well, everyone loved it except my 3-year-old niece. She was not impressed.
Did you see the sun when it was shining so bright?
Nope.
Did it get dark?
No.
Did it get cold?
No.
Did anything happen?
For more astronomical videos, please click to subscribe.